this time we are in Pemberton and we are going to do some marron fishing. We are basically going to cook marron for this whole trip. So we're staying here for around five nights, and we're just gonna catch marron during marron season. We are going to cook marron, hopefully for breakfast, lunch and dinner. And we are going to try out some recipes. Well, I guess we're just gonna experiment with different ingredients, different flavors. So there's no real recipe we're following. I mean, there'll be some tempura marron. There'll be some crumbed marron. Anyway, so this is it. This is our camp spot for a few days, more than a few days. We're on the Warren River and we're going marron fishing. So we're ready with three. I'm gonna hook up my nets with his balls and then we'll go down and catch some marron. Down here is a track going down to the river.
You wanted to make a lure for a trout. That's where you'd emulate.
Yeah, I reckon he's big.
Yeah, so we got seven all up. We cut them up last night, but it got late. So Anthony sliced a few down the middle, long ways, and put a bit of garlic and butter and chili in it. Simple. Basically, Anthony fried a few of those up, they were beautiful. And then the ones that I prepared opened up and got the meat out, it was too late in the night because the recipe I had in mind was just to, it was basically crumb prawns. So we thought we'll just marinate these marron overnight and save them for lunch. So let's have a look and see what I've done. All right, so what we got here is an angle. That's our fridge, by the way. You can see there's lots of tasty treats in there. Mostly healthy, mind you. Look at that bag of junk. Well, first of all, lots of carry up coriander. Lots of coriander, half a bunch, chop it all up. Finally, put it in a bowl. Two cloves of garlic, just chop them up. Like really finely, but make sure they're crushed. Make sure the garlic's crushed. So if you've got a crusher, or chop them up and then crush it with a knife. Side of the knife, just push down into it. And that just crushes it, mushes it up, releases all the juices. Then put that in the bowl. So you get the coriander, the two garlic, and then lots of cracked pepper. Ah, lots of cracked pepper. Actually, no, not in this recipe. Just a little bit of cracked pepper. And then get a lime and then grate all of the rind into the in the mixture. And then get the juices, cut it in half, squeeze all the juices and get all of it out of there into the bowl. Then a chili, of course. This is Thai style. Do we say that? It was Thai style?
Thai style marron.
Thai style marron. So a chili, like really finely, get it really fine because you want those chili flavors to release in the whole mixture. So get them in the bowl. And then what else? Yeah, this helps. Yeah, so the coriander, actually, I had a bit of dry coriander as well. Just dry coriander, dried coriander, just a couple of teaspoons of that. That introduces like an earthy coriander flavor. Whereas the fresh coriander adds a fresh taste. So you got fresh and earth, coriander is one. And that's pretty much it. And then the sauce, I did about a tablespoon of fish sauce. This is where the Thai sort of flavors start to come in, the Thai and the coriander and the chili. Now I'll put a little bit of water in it to create a bit more juice, just a little bit, because we want to make a bit of a sauce out of it as well. I don't know. I reckon we'll be eating Thai style marron. So basically what I'm doing is destroying the flavor of the marron.
Enhancing.
No, you don't enhance it. You destroy it. The best way to do marron is just butter and marron. If you really want to taste the marron, that's what you do. Just butter and marron. But then you can add garlic and you add a bit more. But this, we're destroying it. But we're going to hold the texture and hopefully a little bit of marron comes through in that.
All right.
Now, that's obviously the main part of the dish. We're just gonna put a bit of rice, rice noodle. It's like a Thai style noodle. We've got a pot pan. I'm gonna fill this up with water. All right, got some water here. You know, that's good. It's not too strong. I was worried that it would be really, really strong. All the ingredients that I've put in. But it's just so Thai, and you know Thai isn't a very rich cuisine. These are gonna take about 2 minutes, so that's fine. These, I'm gonna fry them in shallow vegetable oil. Now we'll see how that goes. Now I'm gonna get this pan as hot as I can. The quicker you cook them, more tender it is, and you get that bit of smokiness. So I wanna time it right. And we're gonna eat it straight away because it's seafood, it needs to be hot. Now, it's probably sacrilege to some viewers, but I am going to break that. I don't need long. I just want to stop it. I want to stop it when I can see all the transparency's gone, they've turned opaque. Now I tell you, once we get one of these on there, so lime, fresh lime. Oh, look, so much lime, I hope you do, Anthony. got to have another one.
How's the taste, Chris?
I tell you what, this is a good dish if you don't like seafood. The texture is still there. And as long as you get flavours right that want to replace that marron flavour, you better have some, Anthony.
But I'm not a real chef. Do you want it in a bowl or a plate?
Yeah, plate.
You tell me. Is it good?
No, that's good, man.
Like, really good or just good?
I don't know. It's
very tight. Alright, we'll have to get some more marron and make some more of this.
That's nice. Now you can finish lying.